What's up, YouTube? So before we get started with this video, on First Take, we're going to be talking about how the San Francisco 49ers are finally ranked number one. So let's see what they have to say about that.
I'm going to save that for this team, the San Francisco 49ers. Richard Sherman, shut your mouth. I got a right to sit up there and go against the grain and say, you brothers are real, you brothers are bad. I'm not going to be Michael Irvin. Keep the same intensity. Please don't lose the intensity. Please, the same intensity. Keep it. No, Richard Sherman, I'm not doing that because y'all don't deserve that. You deserve to be recognized as a top team in the National Football League because that defense is real. It is surreal. Obviously, you got a top running game. Kittle is a bad boy at the tight end spot. I still don't know about porn star Jimmy, but I'll find out about him. He's the lone question mark for the San Francisco 49ers right now. I'm going to give it where it's due. That's my top.
I'm glad you...
Yeah, I thoroughly agree with Stephen A. Smith. The San Franciscos are the real deal. My only question is Jimmy Garoppolo still. The 49ers defense is just a bunch of savages on that side of the ball. And I can't wait to see the next up-and-coming games to see who's going to really take charge of the NFC. So let's continue.
Finally caught up to me. I told you last week the Niners should be number one.
Both the Saints should be number two. I'm going to keep that same energy for the Saints. The Saints went undefeated without Drew Brees. 5-0. Now he back, and they are going to rip the doors. I told y'all before the season started. Everybody, look, I'm a Cowboy fan, and we break the Cowboys down non-objectively sometimes, except when you get under my skin. With that being said, the Saints were my pick from the NFC to go to the Super Bowl. Like, this team
they
is
were our pick.
They were our pick. This team to me, when you look, when now we picking hairs, right? We at the point of the season where we these
splitting
teams
hairs,
are who they are. We splitting hairs. I'm taking Drew Brees.
So am I.
I don't care what anybody says.
You know what? Marcus Spears isn't wrong. He definitely is not wrong because New Orleans Saints are bad. They are bad. What are they, what, like 8-1 right now? These boys are out of control. That's what I'm saying. We're really going to have to see what happens in the next couple weeks to see who's the king of the NFC. My only knock on them, the reason why I put the 49ers in front of the Saints, is because they're undefeated right now. That one loss kind of derails the number one spot for the New Orleans Saints. Other than that, it's pretty much neck and neck. So let's continue.
Because he's rested now, not like last year.
You're missing a key pivotal
point.
My list is mobile.
I got you.
How are you going to put anyone ahead of an undefeated team?
I got you. I understand, but we just had a conversation earlier about who you played.
And here's what you're missing. They got to go to San Francisco. Now, obviously, that's not like Cincinnati, Baltimore, someplace.
Who has to go to San Francisco?
If New Orleans, the place for the beginning of the day, New Orleans would have to go to San Francisco. The road to the Super Bowl would have to come through San Francisco. If New Orleans was home and San Francisco had to come to the Dome, I would have picked New Orleans to lose 2 years in a row on their home turf in an NFC Championship game. They were talking a different story.
I just say one thing? We talked about black cats to start the show, running around the franchise with the Cowboys. Yes, that really happened at MetLife Stadium. Stop. You're creeping me out.
Dr. Evil.
But seriously, isn't it about time the Saints also catch some breaks?
Man,
I mean, how many plays?
That's a great point.
They get
the Minnesota miracle.
Terrible
then the
following year.
Look, so they might be getting, you know, a tough time from the officials, but guess what? They're still winning. They're still in a driver's seat, and they're still putting in work. So, you know what? As far as I'm concerned, the New Orleans Saints are right where they should be, right in the driver's seat to take over the NFC, just like the San Francisco 49ers. So, as far as I'm concerned, officiating hasn't done much. So, let's continue.
Remember a time
if
where
any
one team
deserves it, in my opinion.
In one team over the course of like almost a year now has been so consistently victimized by poor officiating. That stuff's supposed to come
it's
out
bad.
And watch.
Honestly, the Saints probably should be in both Super Bowls back to back.
They should be getting some good calls this year.
It's crazy to think. Look, this team is complete though. Like we have we always talk about. First of all, Alvin Kamara ain't playing right now. I don't think people realize how big that is for this team to be playing.
Oh, we realize that. We know what's going on. We see what's going on, Mr. Spears.
He wasn't playing with
Teddy Bridgewater. You're right.
By the way, and no one really, how much better did they look once Breeze got back? Bridgewater was doing well enough.
Michael Thomas literally could be in the MVP conversation. A receiver could be in the MVP conversation.
Yeah.
So
top to bottom.
And you look at the defense side of the ball. Cam Jordan as good as anybody right now. Like, this is a complete team, man.
It's a complete team.
No question.
Team.
But again,
it's
so
a complete
much
team with a quarterback you trust. And unlike last year, where at the end of the season in the playoffs, you're like, Drew Brees is making some questionable decisions. The arm doesn't look because he had to play the whole season. But this could be a blessing in disguise. He got a nice rest while he's rehabilitated.
Yeah.
And now he's back. There's going to be more tread on the tires.
Guess who give him problems?
And there's going to be major trouble with Drew Brees being back. And I can't wait to see all these boys play against each other in the next upcoming weeks, because it's going to be a shootout in the NFC. So let's continue.
The Patriots?
Guess who get
Cowboys. Cowboys?
They do.
Sure.
Yeah.
Just match up with them great.
Sure. You know, I'm glad you keep saying that. You know, you keep holding on to that. Hold on to that dream. It's good for you.
Saints got a good run defense, though. That's good against the